Yeah, good morning students. Let us see the fifth chapter in process control, process line diagrams, the symbols and standards. So normally for a civil engineer, you are going to have a drawing. With the help of the drawing is to this is a simple P&I diagram of a power plant. So whenever you are going to design a power plant, you are going to the first step you are going to have a drawing. So that kind of drawing you call it as a piping and instrumentation diagram. So what you are seeing now is a typical P&I diagram of a power plant. So here in a power plant you are going to see various kinds of sensors, actuators, that is control valves, etc. So each and every sensor will be represented by a code. Each and every control valve also will be represented by a symbol. So in this class we are going to discuss about the various codes which are used to represent the P&I diagrams. So first, coming to the general instruments. So general instruments means sensors like ammeters, voltmeters, flow meters. This we call it as a general instruments. They are normally represented in a circle. It's called a balloon circle. Sorry, a balloon. So inside that balloon, we are going to write the code. The code will specify So the code which you are going to write inside that particular circle will give the information regarding the function and the nature of the device. So this is the circle or the balloon which we had seen in the previous slide. It is an instrument. If it is locally mounted, you are going to have just a round circle, that's all. If it is an instrument which is located in the control room or the control center, you are going to have a line in between the circle. Suppose if at all an instrument is performing two or more services, or we call it as a bifunctional, you are going to see overlapping circles. And if the instrument is transmitting the data to a remote location, we are going to see a cross inside the circle. So these are some of the symbols how a level meter or a flow meter is represented. The first one here you are going to see is the different types of level measurement. The basic type which you are going to see is the flow type of level measurement. So if you are going to use a sensor, a flow type level sensor, you are going to have a symbol like this. So in the drawing, you are going to represent like this. If it is an internal ball flow type level meter. If it is a displacement type float meter, you are going to have the symbol like this. If you are going to use a level gauge, or you call it as a differential pressure meter, it is represented like this. If it is a side glass type, or we call it as a gauge glass, we are going to represent by this symbol. And this is for the side class. Coming to the flow meters, so different types of flow meters we are going to see is the orifice meter, venturi meter, turbine flow meter, etc. So if it is an orifice meter, we are going to have a circle with this small opening. If it is a turbine flow meter, you are going to use this symbol. If it is a variable area flow meter like a rotometer, you are going to represent like this. If it is a venturi meter, you are going to use this particular symbol. So these are the various flow measuring symbols. If it is for an orifice, venturi tube, next nozzle, variable area flow meter, turbine flow meter, positive displacement flow meter, electromagnetic flow meter. These are the various gauges like thermometers and other miscellaneous device. If it is a liquid level type, the pressure type or vacuum type, you are going to represent like this. This is bulkhead type, joint, expanded type, fixed type. If it is a displacement type, we are going to represent by a box. If it is an orifice, next a discharge meter or a suction type of meter. These are some of the symbols which are used in power plants. The air ejector, blower, soot blower, boiler steam generator, engine steam, evaporator, pump, reciprocating type of pump, rotary type of pump, turbine steam generator, you are going to represent like this. These are the symbols which you are going to use while drawing the P&I diagrams. Again, I repeat, P&I is piping and instrumentation diagrams. So here you are going to see some other symbols. If it is a coil, pipe, compressor, condenser, condensing unit. So these are some of the units or the devices which you are going to see in a power plant. The condensing unit, water cooled, cooler type, high pressure, low pressure, valve evaporator, automatic valve expansion, manual valve expansion, thermostatic valve expansion. These are the various symbols which we are going to use. Next, coming to the sensors. So here we are going to have different kinds of sensors like for measurement of level, pressure, temperature, etc. So this, the first one is the pressure sensor. It is represented by the box. It will be represented by P. And coming to a level sensor, you are going to represent it by L. Coming to the temperature type, you are going to use it as T. This is a PT100 type. PT stands for platinum 100. If it is a flow sensor, adjuster, analog indicator, these are the various types of converters. We had seen about I2P converter, P2I converter, the pressure transmitters. So coming to the I2P converter, so you will be representing it as E and A. E stands for the voltage or current, A stands for the pressure. So here, next one is the I2P converter. This is I2P converter, this is I2P transmitter, this is a pressure transmitter with electrical signal. So normally in the instrumentation, we have studied about transducers. Next, we are going to hear one more word called as a transmitter. So what is a transmitter is? A transducer which converts one form of energy into a standard form. So in instrumentation, we are going to have two standards. One standard we call it as a pressure standard, another thing we call it as a current standard. In the pressure standard, we are going to use 3 to 15 PSI. So whatever may be the sensor you are going to use, or sensor or transducer, the output of the transducer, or we here we call it as a transmitter, the output will be 3 to 15 PSI. And that kind of output any device is exhibiting, that is, we call it as a transmitter. And one more standard we are going to use is the current standard, that is 4 to 20 milliamp standard. So any transducer which output is in the standard form, that is, whether it may be a current standard or it may be a pressure standard, we are going to call that particular device as a transmitter. If you are using a bellow, Bowden tube or an LVDT for measurement of pressure, and the output of that particular pressure transmitter is say 3 to 15 PSI, and that particular device you are going to call it as a pressure transmitter. So here we are going to be least bothered what is the transducer which is inside that particular transmitter. Simply we are going to represent it as a PT. PT stands for is a pressure transmitter. And coming to the flow transmitter, you are least bothered whether it is an orifice type or venturi meter type or nozzle flow meter. Simply you are going to represent it as a flow transmitter. The output will be a 4 to 20 milliamps signal. Next, coming to the level transmitter, you are going to represent it as LT. And next, these are the different types of symbols. It is a transmitter. Location, if it is placed at the control room, you are going to have a horizontal line. If you are going to use it on a local panel, you are going to use a double line. And if you are going to use a switch, you are going to represent like that. The next, coming to the different types of control valves. Normal control valve you are going to represent like this. If it is a control valve, automatic control valve, you are going to have a semicircle here. If it is a manual valve, you are going to represent like this. Like this is a backdraft damper used for damping. Like this is a needle valve. If it is a butterfly valve, different types of control valves we had seen. If it is a butterfly valve, the symbol will be like this. This is diaphragm valve. This is the ball valve. So these are the various symbols. This is electrically operated. If there is a line in here, this is a hydraulic operated control valve. So these are the various symbols which you are going to use in your drawings. So that kind of drawing, you call it as a piping and instrumentation drawing. We call it as a P and I D symbols, or we are going to call it as a P and I diagrams. P and I diagrams stands for piping and instrumentation diagrams. So if you are going to represent a control valve, a pneumatical control valve, you are going to use a symbol like this. If it is a safety valve, the symbol is like this. If it is a self-actuating valve, you are going to draw like this. And these are some of the other valve symbols. Hand operated. That is a gate valve. Hand operated means you are going to have a straight line like this. So gate valve, hand operated, globe valve, hand operated. Next, this is cock valve. Again, if you are having a straight line, it is a hand operated. Check valve, butterfly valve, angle valve. This is a control valve. If it is a solenoid valve, if it is an electrically actuated thing, electrically actuated valve, that valve you call it as a solenoid valve, you are going to represent it by symbol S. If you are having a motor which is used to drive the control valve, you are going to use the symbol M. If it is a piston operated, the symbol will be like this. If it is a safety valve or relief valve, you are going to use this particular symbol. Next, till now we had seen about different types of walls and sensors. Now we are going to see the symbols for various controllers. So if you are using a pneumatic flow control, the symbol will be like this. If it is a PC pneumatic pressure controller, you are going to use FC stands for flow control. PC stands for pressure control. And here you are going to use, this is EC, this is flow controller FC. And the symbol here you are going to see two lines here. These two lines stands for, it is a pneumatic type. If you are going to see a dotted line, you can see that is an electrical signal. If you are seeing these lines, the input will be a 3 to 15 PSI. If you are seeing these horizontal, dotted lines, the input to this particular flow controller will be a 4 to 20 milliamp signal. This is a current signal and this is a pressure signal. If you are seeing two vertical lines, that is a pneumatic type. If you are seeing the dotted line, it is electrical type or electronic type. The input will be 4 to 20 milliamps. This is a level controller. So different types of controllers we had seen about proportional, integral, derivative, PI, PD, etc. If it is a PI controller, you are going to have a symbol like this. Inside that, it will be written whether it is P or I or PI. So these are the symbols which we had seen in the previous slide, very important. If it is an electrical line, you are going to represent it by a dotted line. Suppose if I am taking an input from a sensor and the output of that particular transmitter or the sensor is an electrical form, you are going to represent it by a dotted line. If it is a pneumatic type, you are going to have vertical lines. If it is a hydraulic type, you are going to have a straight line with symbols, L symbols on that particular line. If it is a capillary line, you are going to have cross marks on that particular line. If it is a fluid pressure line, you are going to have a simple straight line. If it is a process line, you are going to have the very bold line here. If you are going to take a measurement from one particular place in that particular plant, you are going to represent it with a X symbol. So if there is any obstruction, like if you are going to use a flow meter in the stream of the flow, you are going to connect an orifice meter. So if you are going to connect any orifice meter like that, you are going to use this particular symbol. It states that an orifice meter is installed in the line. And this is, if that particular line, if that particular area you are going to use by using a laser Doppler flow meter or some ultrasonic flow meter which uses some kind of ultraviolet radiation, you are going to use this particular symbol. This is an undefined signal line. If you don't have any clarity on that, you are going to represent with a single vertical line here. And if you are going to use the electromagnetic signal, the representation will be like this. If it is an internal link, you are going to have a line and a circle. If it is a mechanical link, so the symbol is like this. If it is a binary signal means the signal will be a digital input or digital output. The input or output will be in the form of ones and zeros. If you are getting that kind of input or output, you are going to represent it like this. If it is a pneumatic binary signal, pneumatic binary signal means if I want to switch on the control valve or if I want to switch off the control valve, you are going to use this representation. That is called as a pneumatic binary signal. Whenever pressure input is there, the control valve will be switched on. Whenever the pressure input is absent, the control valve will be switched off. So these are the other line symbols. So next, you are going to have some kind of procedures or instructions. In some applications, what you are going to do is you are going to use a combination of instruments. A combination of instruments means for measurement as well as control. So here, at some points, the same device will be used for multiple kind of measurements. So that now we are going to see about that. You are going to use some kind of suffix letters. So for example, where you are going to have valve positioners, for a valve positioner you are going to use the air sets, switches, relays. So each and every relay, a valve positioner has to be connected to the concerned control valve. So for this you are going to use the codes like this. So here you are going to use some kind of letter codes. So the letters of English alphabets are used in the letter code. So all the codes will be written in uppercase letters. So the maximum letters will be, 3. In some specified applications like PH or if there is any kind of gas measurement, you are going to use, suppose if you are going to measure a gas called as a CO2, you are going to simply write it as CO2. The complete CO2 will be considered as a single character. The first letter will indicate the process variable. The second and third letter will be used for the combination letters. So the three letter word will don't have any kind of hyphens in between. So this is like this. So normally the identification letters will be A to Z. The first letter will be the measured value, or we call it as an initiating variable. Second letter will be a readout, and third value will be an output. Say for example, if you are going to use a letter called as A, first letter, it represents analysis. If I am going to measure the burner or flame, the first letter starts with B. If I am going to measure the conductivity at one particular place, the device, that number lettering will start at C. If I am going to measure the density, it starts with, these are the standards which you have to use. So D stands for the density, or you are going to use it for specific gravity. E stands for the voltage. If you are going to measure any voltage, or you are going to represent voltage, you are going to use a letter called as E. If you are going to measure the flow, it is represented by F. If you are going to use gauging, you are going to represent it by G. If it is manually initiated by hand, you are going to use a letter called as H. If it is a current, you are going to represent it by I. Power, normally you are going to express it in joules, so represented by J. If it is a timing device, you are going to use a letter called as a K. L for level, M for moisture, N for user's choice. You can use it for any application you require. O is also user's choice. P represents pressure, Q represents quantity, R represents radioactive thing, S represents speed, T represents temperature, U is a multivariable function, V for vibration or viscosity, W represents weight, force, Y represents the present state or the event, Z represents the position or the dimension. So this is these are the two letter words. We had seen that first letter will indicate the quantity. So for example, P. P stands for pressure, A stands for alarm. So on any device, if it is represented as a PA, we call it as a pressure alarm. If it is SR, it is called as, S stands for speed, R stands for recorder. So it is speed recorder. FE, F stands for flow, E stands for sensor, so flow sensor. T stands for temperature, I stands for indicator, temperature indicator. So TW stands for temperature well, FT stands for the flow transmitter. So whenever you are drawing the piping and instrumentation diagram, if you are going to write it as a pressure alarm, you are going to represent it as by a symbol called as a PA. The PA will represent it as a pressure alarm. If it is a TA, it represents a temperature indicator. If it is written FT, you are going to represent it as a flow transmitter. If it is PIC, three letter word, it is pressure indicator as well as controller. HCV, it is hand control valve. PCV, it is a pressure control valve. So these are the two letter, three letter words which are used in your drawings. So next, let us talk about one more topic called as BIS. We call it as a standards. So normally in India, we are going to use a standard called as a ISI standard or ISI mark. So whatever the goods or things which has a service, which has a symbol, ISI symbol, you are going to call that particular instrument as a standard instrument. So like that, in instrumentation we are having different kinds of standards. So we are going to see about that particular standards now. The first standard is the BIS standards. So we call it as a Bureau of Indian Standards. So it is a government organization which was set up in the year 1947. So after that it has been ISI and it has been changed to BIS in 1987. So what these BIS people will do is, they are going to develop the standardization of any instrument or equipment or any gadget which they are going to get into the market, starting from the raw material to the finished product. They are going to go for the standards starting from the raw material to the end product. So if for any device you are going to have a ISI mark or a BIS mark, like for gold you are going to use a hallmark. If it is a hallmark standardization, you can buy, since it is a standard device. So what is the need or the objective is, which has a complete quality. The main importance is, that is a BIS, we call it as a ISI mark, which will guarantee you, the purchaser, that the goods with the mark have been manufactured under a well-defined quality control. So directly you can buy this particular device or the equipment. So in instrumentation they had given some standards. We will see some two or three standards. This is IS. IS stands for Indian Standards. QC stands for quality control. Some number and the year. So in the 1994 they had given a standard for thermistors. So if anyone making a thermistor in India, they have to follow that particular standard. So what the standard will tell you is, what should be the size of the thermistor, what should be the quality of the thermistor, what should be the output of a thermistor, what should be the color of the thermistor, everything will be defined in that particular standard. So that standard is given by the Indian Standards and it is represented by ISQC 44000. It was in the year 1994 they had given a standard for the thermistors. Next, if you are going to use a photovoltaic devices, if it is a standard device, it has to come under IS 12762. They had given it in the year 1989. The output of the photo transistor should be like this, the color should be like this, the size should be like this, the operating temperature should be like this. So everything they will be mentioning in that particular standard. This is for pH meter standard they had given in 1972. It is given by IS 6804. The specifications of thermocouple they had given 7358, IS 7358, they had incorporated in there 1984. Next, another standard is called as an ANSI standard, called American National Standard Institute. Like in India we have BIS standards, we have another standard called as ANSI standard, American National Standard Institute. It is a individual organization, nowhere related to the government. So normally the government offices, private organizations, corporations, other international bodies are using these standards. So normally ANSI standards they had given ISO certification. ISO 9000 stands for the quality. ISO 14000, these are the certificate numbers. If any company is having ISO standards, ISO 9000, they'll give it as ISO 9000, 4001. So it represents the quality. ISO 14000 will give you about the environmental standards. Environmental, if I am going to start an industry, if I am going to get a standard from the ANSI, say ISO 14000, we call it as environmental friendly. Environmental friendly means with the help of that particular company or organization or industry, it don't have any effect on environment. That particular industry is not going to create any kind of pollution and all, you are going to get a certificate called as ISO 14000 certificate. ISO 14000 certificate means that particular industry or organization is environment friendly. So around 125,000 companies are having this particular ISO standards. So these are some of the standards. If you are going to use a SCADA type of system, supervisory control and data acquisition, the standard is given in the year 1994. The document which is pertaining to that particular SCADA is given by C37.1. And if it is an electrical measuring instrument, null balancing electrical instrument, the standard for that is given by the number 39.4, C39.4. So electrical and electronics, C42. Direct acting electrical recording instrument, the standard is written in C39.2 in the year 1964. Next, another standard we are going to talk about is BSI standard. It is called as the British Standard Institute. So like America has having ANSI, India is having ISI. So like that same British is having BSI, that is a British Standard Institute. So every country will have their own standards. For example, a kg or the weight, we are going to measure it in kgs, where the other people, they are going to use it in pounds. So pounds is a standard there, kgs is a standard here. So they, we are going to talk about our Indian standards, the British people, they are going to talk about their British standards. So BSI provides again the same ISO 9001, again stands for the quality, ISO 14001 environmental, and OHSC, that is occupational health and safety engineering. The company follows the safety instructions, or if the company is having hygienic health, if it is going to take care about the health of the employees, like for example in a mining industry where the employees are will be working in a very hard environment where they are very prone to different kinds of accidents, that particular company is taking about the care of the employees regarding the safety and health, and that particular company will be awarded with the OHSA certificate, that is the occupational health and safety. This is a standard of BSI for thermocouples that is given in the document BSEN 60584. They had given it in the year 2008. And the different standards for transmitters is given by BSEN 60770. Next, there is another standard called as ISC, called as Instrumentation System and Automation Society. Normally, we call it as a Instrumentation Society of America, or we call it as Instrumentation System and Automation Society. This is a US standard exclusively for instrumentation. So, it is going to develop the various standards of ISA, involves in the design, development and production of the various applications and devices. So these are some of the standards, say ISA 5.1. It will give you the standards. In the previous slides we have seen the what are the symbols and the identification of various instrumentation devices. So that is represented in the document ISA 5.1. ISA 5.3, the graphical symbols. 5.4, the loop diagrams. 5.5, the graphical symbols. 5.20, the standards for industrial automation and control. ISA 75, the control valve standards. This is another standard, a Dutch standard, we call it as DIA. We call it as a Deus Institute Norman, DIN, is an English, it's a German institute for standardization. It's founded in 1917. It has a headquarters in Berlin. It is recognized by the government of Germany in 1975. These are some of the DIN standards for instrumentation. Like we are going to have standard sizes of paper, A4, A5, legal. So that standard was given by DIN, DIN 476. So the DIN 476 standard will talk about the international paper sizes, the postcard size, letter size, that everything is by DIN 476. Next, coefficient of friction is given by the standard DIN 946. And the traffic signals for railways is given by DIN 1451 standard. The transliteration of one language to another language, converting of one language to another language, we call it as a transliteration. It is given by the standard 31635. And coming to the automobile electrical terminals, it is given by DIN 7255. So this is about the piping diagrams and about the various standards. We had seen about BIS standards, ISA standards, DIN standards, etc. So the complete PPT is available in the following link, which you can download. Thank you.